What's up, rock.comers? It's Martini Beerman. I'm currently at the House of Blues. You know this group of guys from their smash hit Hey There Delilah, and you've probably been rocking out to them on the radio with their latest Rhythm of Love. They're playing White Tees, and they're out here on tour right now promoting their latest album, Wonders of the Younger. It's Plain White Tees, and here's what they have to say. I'm hanging out with the Plain White Tees right now. We're at the House of Blues, and you guys are performing this evening, which is amazing. Are you stoked?
I mean, we're playing a huge portion of the set that is new songs, and we're really vibing the new stuff, and it's been fun.
So. You guys are on tour promoting Wonders of the Younger. It is definitely a change from your former albums, and you guys have taken a couple leaps with this album. Do you want to describe that to rock.comers, how you feel like this album is different?
I think we made a huge effort to really expand our sound on this record. You know, we recorded it differently. We spent a lot more time writing. It took a lot more time getting specific sounds. You know, if there was a certain, instrument we were looking for, or a certain tweak in an effect, we spent a lot of time on it. You know, on the last record, we set up in a room live and just played. You know, and this time around, I think we focused on making sure that the finished product was massive sounding. You know.
And you guys have taken a lot of risks, I think, even with your arrangements, correct? I mean, which song would you say is the biggest leap arrangement-wise?
I mean, Irrational took a long time in the studio to get straight because there's, three different tempos in the song? Didn't seem to go together at all, you know? We were, putting them together and they were almost, abruptly changing. Man, we can't do that on the record. And so we just sit there gradually tweaking it until it seemed to make sense, you know?
And a song called Cirque Don LaRue, I think, is pretty... That arrangement-wise, literally, if you structured it out, is pretty unique, I think. But, you know, those two songs are some of the most exciting songs on the album. So I think taking those chances and going places you don't expect it to go is kind of what the album was all about.
You know, there's definitely that whole circus theme that you guys are going for. Am I completely off balance here?
No, I mean, we actually had the name Wonders of the Younger before we wrote any of the album. So we knew kind of the way we wanted it to feel and, the mood that we wanted it to evoke. But, getting there was kind of a challenge. You know, we wanted it to be adventurous. I don't know if we'd go circus, but I mean, all those circus, pirates, vampires, you know, we tried to ghost in the graveyard. I mean, all the kind of, outlaws,
Yeah, no one who's never heard the record will know what the hell is going on right now.
You gotta hear it and find out.
What are you guys listening to right now on the radio?
You know that song, All I Do Is Win, and No Matter What? And then it's like, everybody's hands go up, and they stay there, bam, and it slams back in. I love that song.
In your video for Rhythm of Love, there's definitely this portion where people are pelting you with things, and you start laughing hysterically. Was that planned at all?
No. The director was standing behind the crowd going, do not hit the singer, and do not hit the camera. And, I mean, these kids, it was like apes at the zoo. Like, they were throwing feces or something. I got hit every take that we did in the face, and they hit the camera every time. So it's like, did you guys not play softball or baseball or any sort of thing that required hand-eye coordination when you were children?
I think they were going for you on purpose.
Maybe so. They're like, I hate this song, and that guy's got a smug look on his face.
I feel like when I listen to your lyrics, obviously with Rhythm of Love and even with Boomerang, I listen to your songs and I'm like, I kind of get a sense that these guys are more sensitive guys, you know? But at the same time, do you feel like to write lyrics and to perform lyrics, you have to give some of yourself in order to, make a connection with your audience?
A lot of it is personal. There was actually a song on the album called Last Breath that that I didn't want on the album because it was kind of too dark and too personal. But, the guys all loved it. I gave in eventually, obviously. I'm like, fine, we'll do it. And now it's actually one of my favorites, too. So sometimes the more personal you are, the more people can connect with that and the more it means to them. So it's good to put it all out there. Hey, we're the Plain White Tees. You're watching rock.com. My heart beats like a drum, a guitar string to the strum of beauty.